Welcome back to OtakuDaiKun. I'm Dai.
And this is Adi-chan.
We're going to be playing some Tales of Berseria. Man, I love this game. In fact, it's probably one of my favorite games in the series now. Mostly for its character development. I really like the way that they handle the story and the characters. Maybe not so much the exploration, but you'll definitely get a chance to see what I'm talking about. Let's jump right on in. On the night of the Red Moon. Oh shit.
Shit goes down.
It's on fire!
That's always beautiful. Yeah, you
Ufotable.
Ufotable bringing the awesome.
Oh, that guy dead.
I'm sad.
Oh, man.
Oh.
You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
Little baby Velvet and Lafayette getting saved by Arthur.
I'll come back for you once Celica is safe.
Aw.
Run away!
Ah, oh, shit.
This guy tells me everyone is going to die.
Yeah, but that's Celica's voice.
Arthur, help us!
How do you know that?
Say what? Oh, shit. Boy, be shanked. Oh. And there goes the arm. You're gonna die! Ugh. The action scenes in this are really cool.
I really love how they switched to the mocap style for these games. It just adds that extra level of realism and intensity to like
on that
everything.
Day, the world began to change.
Oh, yes.
Men and beasts.
She devours the demons, which if you've played Zestiria, you know are actually Hellions.
Only two things matter to me.
You got a kitty.
The taste of blood-soaked flesh.
Oh boy. I don't know what that tastes like,
and
Velvet.
Revenge upon one man.
Flashback.
Hi.
She's so happy.
And you're not shanked.
I'm not a little kid anymore.
Oh, you're a good boy.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good.
Looks
bit of
happy.
A fever, I'm afraid.
Well,
at least the new medicine's supposed
sick.
To come today.
Well, bat, bat.
Until then, the you stay in bed. Got it?
Oh yes, happy village.
I wanted to go to
and
the
healthy
cave.
And bright.
Sorry, you'll have to wait. Can I at least read a book?
No reading for you.
Oh.
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
It's okay. Books are lame.
I didn't
mean... That's why we have visual novels. Oh, this is absolutely gorgeous. This first map just really took me in. Look at the lighting.
And just the shadows. I mean, it's all related, obviously, but...
We're gonna go hunting now. Gotta pay for that medicine by beating up the piggies.
You deserve this?
They tasted too damn good. Well, they do fight back a little bit.
Oh, sorry.
It's nothing like the sheep in Grandia 3. The sheep in Grandia 3, that's intense.
Kills me every time.
Not bad.
We did it.
Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them.
Raise
but
the piggies.
They can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred
more
docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkle boars?
Oh, that'd be cute. That'd be so adorable.
Doesn't sound appetizing. What about piggle boar? Hmm. Yeah, piggle boar. That's a cute name.
I like oinkle boars.
Kill the piggle boars. Kill the piggle boars.
Know your foes and strike where they're weak.
Where are they weak? Right in the schnozzles.
This should be enough to cover the medicine.
Nice.
I'd better bring these to the store.
Whee! Oh, a couple attacked us on the way home.
Oh.
Evidence.
One of them's infected.
It's consuming me! The T-virus. This is a zombie pig. Oh.
An exorcist art.
Pride and anxiety. Pity for the enemy. Thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be.
Well, Velvet is hot. What do you expect?
She was just born this way.
Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
He's crazy.
He's got invisible friends. Imaginary.
Arthur?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Velvet, run away right now.
Because it's their instinct, you idiot. Have you ever heard of evolution?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
Because it's fun.
Because wings was a biological efficiency for their environment. And the ones that had wings and could fly got more food and sex.
Yahoo! Skip off.
Mika, here for groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out hunting.
Yeah.
Yeah, we incinerated the entire forest.
Look at you, lady breadwinner. If you were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Can't have lesbians in here.
Yeah, that shouldn't stop you.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb, so get a new one.
Just how much does a comb cost when you can buy weapons at a store?
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Oh, Velvet, I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
Aw, shit.
Damn Trump care. What?
Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight...
No, it's because they've defunded healthcare. There's even a group of There's nothing we can do about it.
But we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore.
If he can't jack off, how do you expect him to protect us?
Wife and child.
Oh, damn.
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche.
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your
quiche.
Eye on?
Quiche? Sounds really good about now.
Beyond serious? Please.
Oh,
this
veterinarian's a good life choice, man.
I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you.
Busy as hell, making some good money.
She's got doggies.
Yeah.
The important thing is my feelings.
Yes. She voices like Kaunon and God Eater. I like
if
her voice
I were
a lot.
A boy, I think I'd be in love. Darn right.
Aw.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been
so Velvet's
seven
sister
years since we lost you.
And her baby got killed that night.
What's this?
A compass.
It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy?
Don't crush his dreams, Velvet.
Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the
she
ocean.
She doesn't understand the adventurer's pride.
It's designed to stay level. So your heading will be true, even when the ship is rolling with the waves.
Woo!
Pretty neat, right?
Rolling. Huh?
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure.
You just Can't don't you get it, gosh.
You never get me, Velvet.
You can tell me more about it later. No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
He can see the Malakim.
I can tell you've been learning all
he can
sorts
see that
of
person that Arthur was talking about.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world.
That sounds cool. That's like Saray's dream.
I'll chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you.
Some ideas are very universal.
I wish I could do that. Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Dun dun dun.
Yeah. Just like that night that changed our lives.
Aw, piss.
Foreshadowing.
Velvet, may I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course.
Oh, yeah.
Hey,
no incest over here.
No incest, no.
I haven't seen him.
You damn Butterfingers, you dropped the book.
That's one of Arthur's.
I didn't steal
Actually,
it, I swear.
It's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
I don't think so.
Luffy,
when you find out what it was
really
about.
Copy all that by hand? Oh, he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes.
Puppy eyes.
Told him I'd throw it in for free. But he said that it would be a bad deal for me.
How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Lottie?
Apple boo?
That sounds delicious.
Grated apples. Mm-hmm. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart.
Apples are a major
and juicy and crisp. Eating it all
theme, I suppose, in this game.
Well,
motif.
Apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
Boo!
When I was a baby, I would always say boo boo when I wanted to eat an apple.
Not scary.
So
apples.
That's where the name comes from. Wait, Dull. You called apples boo boo? You must have been a strange baby.
Not when they throw them at you and you get bruises.
When Celica and I heard you, we laughed.
How about them
boo boos? So hard.
Boo. Oh no. You try to enjoy one day of your simple lives and the werewolf comes to ruin it.
Fluffy set, run! No matter how much it hurts!
Run away!
Velvet! Don't be scared. You can do it.
You can do it!
To be strong, like
I don't this care, as long as I get one of you.
It's a very demotivated wolf. See, I'm working overtime already. Get this over with. Damn it, you can't hit him? You cheating son of a bitch.
Come on, dude.
You can't even light it on fire. Ow! Crack, aw. That would hurt like a motherfucker. Like, what? I pretty much approach anything that talks to me. I have no strategy, except for bashing. I love to bash. Oh damn! So he transcribed an entire book to get a comb. It's a beautiful sentiment, but God, he got ripped off. Son of a bitch, merchant. Ah! Oh shit. Had only I moved a little faster, I would not be dead.
Something tells me even if he did that.
What, you're saying Arthur was on standby? It's like, oh wait.
Yeah, the perfect timing.
Your old one broke, right?
Mm-hmm.
You've got beautiful hair. Mm-hmm. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it.
Honey, my hair is lovely.
I'd give anything for that kind of strength in my hair.
I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
That doesn't sound ominous at all.
Nope.
Yeah? We're back! I brought some friends. We brought some beers. It's going to be fun.
It's a party.
That's Jeff. Let's go get him. Okay, ow.
Ah! What the fuck, dude?
That would incur severe burning. Do not try this at home.
Like, here, fourth degree once, burns?
The seal to the underworld such a broken. Thing. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the
They're
world.
They're symbolic flames. So this is, of course, the moment that got censored in North America. He's supposed to just shank him through with his sword and drop him into the pit, but, we get something a little bit different, and I actually don't mind it as much, considering this is a magical ritual that he's conducting in the first place. We'll understand a bit more of that later in the game.
But right now, it just fucking sucks.
Shank. The little boy is the sacrifice. What is it, Lassie? Did Timmy fall in the well again? No! Son of a bitch! That's a big well. It's not a well. But that was some good catching, Jesus.
Let him go. This is an offering to the
world. Let him go. Let him go.
If he'd actually just explain this shit to her, you know, probably wouldn't have changed very much, but, you know.
I don't know what's going on! I'm stupid in not telling you. I will shank you.
Ever a slave to emotion.
Yeah, I think anyone would be emotional after this shit.
Yeah, kidding.
Yo, brother. He be dead and fallen.
The photobowl actually rendered the blood on his chest.
And there's dragon in the well. He's like, ah, a tasty morsel for me. Nom, nom, nom.
Fuck!
Christina V is stellar in this role, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Good at her screams. Lots of vocal straining for someone who's so pushed to their boundaries. Whoa. What was that? Bleh. This one didn't taste so good. I'm spitting it back out. And she is forever changed.
She's got the power.
Yeah. Next time you shouldn't shank her in the hand. It'll manifest into power.
Imagine if you like cut off her head or something.
That would be weird looking. Fuck you! This is where the rage comes in. Of course, Berseria equals Berserk. She going crazy.
Literally.
Fuck you. I love the choreography. She's just tossing them every which way like ragdolls.
I guess he didn't mean to do that.
Battle! Smack! There's something really satisfying about just clawing the shit out of them. This game handles cathartic emotional release very well.
Good after a long day of work.
Just hearing Velvet screaming her ass off like killing things. It has its appeal for the tragedy of the story. Aww. It's like, now I have to face werewolves! What do they have to do with this? But they ain't no werewolves no more.
Shit.
Oh, you killed your friend.
She didn't know. No one really knowing.
So demons, hellions, whatever you want to call them,
they're
people.
Demon blood has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an
exorcist. Nice try.
I, Artorius Colbrand, will end your pain.
If you did, we wouldn't have a game, would we?
That's true, good point. Who are you?
Ceres.
Okay, so that's the chick that's been chilling out with him that Velvet couldn't see, but Lafayette could. A Malachim, or, if you'd like to call it what it is in Zestiria, the Seraphim.
Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer, Velvet.
Because fried chicken is delicious.
I ask no forgiveness.
What?
That makes no sense!
So did my world come to an end.
Oh, damn.
And for 3 long years.
3 long years you sat in a dungeon. Devouring monsters.
I sat in that pit of darkness.
In little to no clothing.
And fed. Devouring demons.
Gobble, gobble. Splatter, splatter.
So
that's
I
hardcore.
Could live. So I could live long enough to kill him.
Revenge!
My brother's vengeance.
For Lafayette! But one day, help arrives. In the form of cleavage.
There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of...
This is Monica Real, I believe. She's a veteran of this industry for sure. Very good voice actress.
You may find him in the capital city of Logris in Midgand.
Logris? I think that was in Zestiria.
Hmm. I know Midgand was.
These cities are old.
To listen. I can tell you what it was.
I think
they
said something like the 3,000 years difference between the two games.
Yes.
It's pretty crazy.
That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malakim descended, and with
so
their
people
strength,
could see the Malakim again.
Quelled the demon tide.
And people who form pacts with now, Malakim or Seraphim can defeat Abbey, the demons, aka Hellion.
The unconditional faith of the kingdom
and now Arthur's the good guy and the public eye.
And a sword against demons, Artorius Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafiset.
It's horrible.
But his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Just what I like to hear.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
The game is afoot.
So Velvet was being held in here more than just chains and a gate. There's a magical barrier.
We must hurry.
Is that like losing your virginity?
No one raised the alarm.
I can see that.
Take what you need from here.
Mine? Mine?
It looks like they kept prisoners' effects in here.
Rope. This will be useful.
I like quite bandage.
I like bandage!
Stormhowl.
Ooh.
What is it doing here?
That sounds important.
Here we go. The ever controversial but supremely beloved outfit. Filled with all sorts of anime conventions all like right. Overuse of belts.
Impractical.
Try it out. Belts. Yep.
It's like I'll just strap on this piece here.
Velvet don't give a fuck.
She
just doesn't give a shit. Look at that, she's showing some underboob. She don't give a shit.
I'm opening every door to every
jailbreak.
We're getting off this island.
What the hell? You serious?
Oh yeah. Here you are now. Free. Crackle.
Hey.
Woohoo!
Freedom!
TGI Fridays!
Drink some wolf, guys!
Or guards. Or distracted guards.
The outer path down to the docks.
Dear me, not a word of apology?
Where are you? It's Muggy Lou! And she's got good dodging skills.
What's wrong with you people? There I was, sleeping like a sweet babe, when suddenly... From paradise down to hell!
No worse, a grimy prison cell.
You see
her voice is probably my favorite in terms of just
and you are
how advanced you have to be to play this role and make it come off right.
I'm thrilled to introduce to you the wise sorceress who travels the 11 seas, who scoffs at the might of dragons. None other than the acclaimed, the illustrious, Majikiki Kafilu Dindo Dino Narundu. Maggie Lou for short.
What kind of name is that?
Maggie Lou.
Nope, not Maggie.
Yeah, like Soggy Shoe or Doggy Doo, or call me any of those things and I'll turn you into a froggy stew.
She probably had to practice that a lot.
I suppose you'll never understand.
As someone with a hard to pronounce name, I completely empathize.
That's why I say anime instead of anime, because it's a preference. What the fuck? Hello.
This one.
He's a demon!
Get ready.
Battle.
Hello, character that I will want to play. Always.
Yeah. Rokuro is Ari-chan's main.
I love Rokuro so much.
True enough.
Oh. Well, first you have to kick his
Stop
ass.
Stop beating him up, Velvet! You're gonna ruin his
fucking We need to establish effective communications before we can become a party.
Effective communications?
Beat your ass!
Pretty much.
Do we have an understanding?
Got an awesome anime cutscene here. Well, not anime, but...
She's strong.
Ships in the blades already. riddle these exorcist knives.
You say that like a Shakespeare. Shakespearean character.
Bristle these exorcist knives. Forsooth.
You found it? Where?
My sword?
Do you have it?
Where?
Please,
where? Mine?
Sounds like it's very important to you.
It's in the fucking basement, dude. Chill.
Today's some people, the basement.
Woo!
Many surprises await you.
He's an odd demon.
But kind of cute.
Oh. So much for the dope rope.
The path has collapsed. That rope won't do any good here.
Unless you want bondage. Not really productive, but...
Wait. You're not seriously going to try it, are you?
He fell for I like her attitude. Back at the shrine. If only the game would encourage this kind of thing. Invisible boundaries and all that nonsense. Just like, fuck it!
Like getting stuck on ledges and stuff when she can clearly do stuff like this. You know? It's like,
yeah, but she doesn't like it. Ow!
Ah! Ow.
She takes a lot of abuse. There might be some good things about her having become a demon. She wouldn't have made it this long otherwise.
I see you are truly committed to this.
She's her own doctor, man.
She just popped it right back in there like it was nothing. Whatever.
It's
I do
okay.
This all the time.
I'm a Lego after all.
I would almost think you made an oath. Oscar.
Oscar.
I had no idea an
he is a total grouch.
To this island.
You surprised
what trash
yourself.
Can did you come from?
You're criminals now, are you?
I already know my ABCs, so get the fuck out of here.
No, I'm acting on my own.
A mullet with free will?
So yeah, the Seraphim don't have free will in this case. They are tools, slaves almost, to the exorcist. Which is why we gotta defeat them first. Yep, you kill his buddies first, and it'll make him weaker. And they will be banged with fire! This Moloch's on fire! There we go. Only one of you left. Kiki's ass. This game works off of souls. You kick them, and you hit them, and you stun them or anything like that. You earn souls to keep attacking more. It's the key to combos.
And of course, with all Tales games, elements play a huge role.
Stop it! Let me go!
I broke him.
Oh shit. Oscar actually reminds me a lot of Flynn from Vesperia.
Oh yeah.
At least the armor and sword fighting and the sort of a noble attitude.
Kind of one of those characters.
Oh shit.
No!
Now, if you've played Zestiria, you know what happens to a Seraph slash Moloch that becomes overwhelmed with malevolence.
A Moloch? With demon blight?
Dragon.
It's lost control.
Time to shine.
How?
You broke your skill.
It's like.
Oh, fuck.
A nuclear bomb. Oh.
Here's some blood tail game. Every now and then. Ow! I'll knock him out for a little while. That sucks.
My wounds are fatal. Please. Consume me. Why? A flame burns.
Why?
A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
Does that make you a lesbian? Like me?
This was Laffy's. That is why I cannot abide it. This frozen world. This frozen people.
Damn frozen world needs to be de-thawed, and I need your help.
That stubborn of a woman.
It's frozen.
Falls to...
Oh, whoops.
Hurry. Before my life fades.
So the de-thaw is to freeze.
I guess?
Oh. Here goes Ceres.
I offer no apology or thanks.
I need neither. Our wishes.
Crackle. She's got a pretty face.
And the same.
And very sad eyes.
I treasured those days.
What are you talking about? I just fucking met you.
When you and I and Arthur were together.
Okay, so.
What?
Methinks you're the sister?
But she's a Malekim. It's not the same person.
Doesn't matter, she's dead now.
Aww.
That's horrible. Ring for it. For some reason, Ceres left that behind as a fulfillment of her oath. Time to kill the dragon! And now we can claw the shit out of him and do even cooler arts like this. Oh yeah! Go the dragon!
Like, I'm just trying to flap you.
Hey, man, ow! Aw, oh, cheap shot. You son of a bitch.
Apologies, but I can't let a nasty demon like you roam freely now, can I?
Velvet.
What?
That's my name. You can give Artorias my regards.
Regards. Came for dinner.
Oh shit.
Is Velvet Crow.
We're way over our heads, man.
Oh god, oh man, oh god, oh man.
We're gonna die, man. More homage to the late Bill Paxton there.
Mm-hmm. I have the power of fireball.
Oh. This guy is on fire.
Oh shit. That's actually pretty hardcore.
Oh god. No, Malekim's like,
I'm not a water mallet, dude. Sucks
to
be you.
Throw some dirt on
you. It sucks to be you.
Oh, finally someplace that might not
welcome
be
back, my lovely party.
From the tower, I thought, this is it, Magilu. This is the end.
It would have been famous Magilu hip sway.
Suddenly appeared and jumped on my back.
Like a monkey.
She's a feisty monkey.
It's thanks to you that Storm Howl is back in my care.
Yay!
Woot woot!
Rokurodon gets it. At your service. This blade is my life. I owe you a great debt. One I vow to repay.
Yes, nice. Yes, all I did was tell him it was in the basement.
Can we get a move on?
I wish I had, like, dedication.
Look at
like
those
that.
Dance moves. She's
yes.
So goofy.
Yeah, her animations are spectacular. Magikazam.
Are you a sailor?
No.
Do you know how to pilot a ship?
Between a sail and
not
a
really.
I'll take what I can get. Do what you can.
Gyar, we may not care about these things.
Very well then. I certainly owe you this much at least.
Brave words. But 10 minutes in this storm and you'll lose all sense of direction.
Something tells me we need.
No, we won't. Ships have compasses for a reason.
Now you respect them.
So it's rot in a jail cell or rot in a fish tummy?
Fish tummy.
Guess it's your lucky day, fishy.
Is there a megalodon? Oh, nope. You just crash into the ice. Game over.
Epic fail.
But who are you? You are a kind one, healing my velvet. Not dead yet.
Luffy.
What?
Not quite.
What the fuck? Mine?
I'll take this.
You little thief.
Scampering off somewhere.
You ought to be scampering off yourselves.
Run away.
My debt is not yet repaid. Until it is, I will not leave your side.
I like your loyalty.
I can hardly scamper off without knowing from whence I'm scampering. We're lost, stranded, shipwreck survivors. No.
Gyar, we be in this together. And with that, that concludes our first playthrough of Tales of Berseria. We're going to be bringing you more of these. Definitely let me know what you think. And feel free to subscribe to Otaku Daikun from our anime lists, reviews, discussions, lore videos, and Let's Plays. Until the next video, celebrate your fandom.